Copa Coca-Cola began its roots in Latin America, Southern America, in Mexico. Copa, which basically means cup. So it's a Coca-Cola cup in football.
I do believe all of you players were born later than 1st January 1993. Anything 31st December 1992, not good.
So for us, Copa is a grassroots tournament. You're dealing with kids who are typically under 17 years of age. You're developing them from that level, putting them in camps, getting them training, and then now building them into our future soccer stars.
So our energy is to put football into the youth, make sure that, you know, more people are more involved into sport activities, and especially campaign to bring people back into the fields.
And what we are doing basically is to help all the regions, all the branches, all the provinces to come up with two teams of 16 each, so that they will be participating or competing in the finals, which are going to be held in Nairobi for all the provinces, where we'll pick one team that goes to South Africa for the Copa Coca-Cola.
Copa Coca-Cola in Kenya this year, beginning 2009, promises to be very exciting. What we did in the past was to do primarily inter-school competitions. And what we noticed was, I mean, yes, you'll do your competition, the kids will finish playing, but then now, once the tournament is over, the kids go back to the school and continue their school curriculum. But here comes Copa Coca-Cola, whereby you're playing the tournament, and what we've done differently this year is that as the tournaments go on, both the regional and the national phase, yes, you'll have a winning team, you'll have a second runners-up, and you'll have a third runners-up, but then within the matches we play, we'll be identifying the best talent from those regions.
Football development starts at age 12 or under 12, that's the golden age. But Coca-Cola, in a very good way, they've come in the under 17. That is a beginning, and I'm very delighted really to say that this under 17, when I look very far, in 2014 and 2018, we could have a couple of these players maybe playing for Kenya during those World Cup qualifiers.
I think Copa has been exciting so far. We kicked off the matches in Thika and in Nyeri, and I think even in terms of talent, we've been able to get some pretty good talent from these two areas.
The key area, first of all, in looking at the player, first of all, is the technique. The technique is self-ability in handling the ball. Ball control, heading, passing, weighing the pass, turning, suppleness, and all those other areas. But we have players like Jamal Mohamed, just like Mohamed. Jamal Mohamed is very impressive.
Well, his ball skills are exceptional. He has an eye. He can take one, two, three players, but now he needs to be developed. And that is, our work was only to identify the talent, but now he needs to be developed to know his potential and to know what world beaters are made of.
We have people engaging the crowds, because during any tournament, you'd have the people playing on the pitch and you'd have the guys coming to spectate. So as an addition, we have an MC hyping the crowd, getting them excited, getting them to play games, getting them to stand a chance to win something, like maybe a soda or a branded football or a branded t-shirt. So it's just adding the excitement of music into football.
Mchezaji wa kwanza ni Aspan Mwangi kutoka Spread. Wa pili, Samuel Kabiru.
So what happens once we identify the number one, number two, and number three team, we'll have a small prize-giving ceremony. We'll award the number one team with certificates, medals, and a sports voucher to buy sports equipment. Number two team will get certificates, medals, and three footballs to play with. Number three team also gets certificates, the bronze medals, and now two footballs to play with. At the national level, the stakes are a bit higher.
When we have very good youth development, then we are talking about sports at the top level. I would give a very good example with athletics. Why are we world beaters? Because we start with the junior world championship where we excel. Then coming to the senior, it's automatic. So that is why we say youth development is the key factor for any sports.
The coming of Coca-Cola is very, very timely. In fact, it hits right direct into my trade. I am in charge of youth development in the country. And that's why when the idea came in, you know, I came running, because it's what I've been looking at, you know, trying to look anybody to come in and assist us in youth development. So we are not ready to relinquish this one. Coca-Cola better know that. But our return to Coca-Cola as a company is to make sure that there is success in these programs, and that we realize youth with better talent that can be able to go out there and do the good, give good image.
Well, first of all, I want really to say Coca-Cola, they've done a good job. I want to thank them in a big, big way, because I've always dreamt, every coach has dreamt to go back to the grassroots. They have started in a small way, if I would call it, but I would wish they take up this program not only up to South Africa, but beyond, in that these kids that we are picking today, under 17, can have another program to see them through until maybe they are of Olympic age, which is 23 years. Then they would have said, this is where it started at 17. I would like them to see the boys grow.
I think COPA has been exciting so far. For us as a brand, and for this as a country, we believe it's a very good fit. And then working with our partners again, KPL and FKL, we believe that COPA Coca-Cola is a lot more than just a corporate brand sponsoring football. We're identifying talent, we're investing in the country, and actually investing in our future soccer stars.